So after Paris Agreement, this is the most important COP where we are agreeing on the rule book that's going to determine whether Paris Agreement is real or not. So here we have to agree on the implementation guidelines on each aspect of the Paris Agreement and also put money on the table so that pledges that developing countries have taken, they are able to implement those pledges and plans once they see money coming in. So finance is central to everything that we are doing here in Poland. Whether we talk about ambition, whether we talk about the rule book, you know, different aspects of rule book, whether we talk about transformation that is required in our economies to make them much more greener, or about dealing with impacts. The challenge is that we do not have sufficient money, neither for the transformation of economies nor helping people deal with impacts. Developing countries who did not have any role in causing the crisis are facing the most. So they are the ones who are dealing with the impacts right now on their own. There is no money coming in. And the discussions on loss and damage, which is about how do we deal with impacts that people are already facing, discussions are not moving forward. And if that does not happen here, we will leave poor people and vulnerable people in the lurch. So we need to make sure that support is provided to people who are losing their homes, losing their income, and they are being forced to leave their homes and families behind. So far the money that has been agreed but not yet on the table is $100 billion. The impacts are going to run into trillions. If you look at just the adaptation number, UNEP came up with a report in 2016 saying we will need $280 billion by 2030 every year and $500 billion by 2050 every year. Now that's only for adaptation. But what about people who are losing their homes already? Or in some cases we have to go for permanent relocation, which is going to be extremely expensive and we will require billions and trillions of dollars. So we cannot just put loss and damage under the current $100 billion target. We have to have a separate fund, and because this fund also requires a different way of working. Once developing countries are hit by a disaster, there has to be an automatic system of providing them support, because it's about relief, it's about rehabilitation, it's about reconstruction of their homes and infrastructure. So areas where we have seen some progress, one, displacement. We have seen institutions like International Organization for Migration or Red Cross Movement, Platform for Disaster Displacement, organizations like ActionAid were also involved as part of stakeholder consultations. We all have come together to input into the process and we now have recommendations. If these recommendations are implemented by countries and the global system, I think we are moving forward in protecting people who are getting impacted. So that is positive. We've also seen a lot of progress on identifying issues around non-economic loss and damage. So there's a new stream that is now coming up where we are looking at non-economic aspects. We've also seen a lot more focus on slow onset events such as sea level rise, ocean acidification, increasing pace of desertification. We've seen some progress on the technical side. Where we have not seen progress is the area of action and support, which means how we are now going to implement plans so that it helps people on the ground. Now this is where we are really lagging behind. We are back in Poland, it's 5 years when this Warsaw International Mechanism was established in Poland itself. So good progress on technical side and coordination, but hardly any progress on action and support. So what we want to see, a clear message coming out from here, that we will move forward positively on generating finance, looking into the sources of finance, innovative sources of finance, so that we can create this kind of a solidarity fund going forward. And that political message has to come through.